I'm Mike from the Technical Support Department. In this video, you'll learn programming process and setup for a sensor decoder, including the appropriate use of the ports and the configuration needed according to the type of sensor to be attached to the decoder. Finally, we will show you how to view the decoder configuration and display sensor decoder alarms. The ACC99D allows you to connect a flow sensor or any normally closed click-style sensor through a decoder on the two-wire path back to the controller. To connect a sensor through a decoder, you must use a sensor decoder, also known as ICD SIM. So before programming and installing a sensor decoder, there are some selections that need to be made in the controller based on what type of sensor it is you'll be using. If you are using a sensor decoder to connect a flow sensor, start with the dial in the run position, press and hold the blue information button, move the dial to set flow monitoring, and release the blue information button. Here, you need to choose the type of flow sensor that you are using. Refer to the video on setting up a flow sensor to determine which sensor type to choose. Since we are going to be connecting the flow sensor through a sensor decoder as opposed to directly from the controller, we need to change the location from controller to ADM. If you are using a sensor decoder for a click type sensor, such as a rain click, you need to press and hold the blue information button while turning the dial to set sensor operation and release the blue information button. Here, you also need to change the location to ADM for each sensor input that will be attached to the sensor decoder. So the process for programming a sensor decoder is very similar to the process for programming a station decoder. Turn the dial to the advanced features position. Press the down arrow button to access the decoder functions. And use the plus button to select program a decoder. The controller will detect that it is a sensor decoder. Assign an address from 1 to 5 to the sensor decoder. These are not the same as stations 1 through 5. They are unique to sensor decoders. You can have a sensor decoder number 1 and still have a regular station output number 1 as well. The controller will know the difference. Once the address has been assigned, press the programs button to send the address to the decoder. If the decoder was successfully programmed, it will show programming complete. The ACC controller can accept up to 5 sensor decoders, 1 for flow and 4 more for normally closed click-style sensors. They can be identified by addresses 1 through 5. Sensor decoders have 2 ports, port A and port B. When connecting a flow sensor, be sure to use port A as this is the only one compatible with flow sensors. You also want to pay attention to the polarity as it does matter when connecting the flow sensor. Click type sensors can either use port A or port B. In fact, you can connect 2 click type sensors to a sensor decoder or a combination of a flow sensor and a click type sensor. So the last step in configuring the sensor decoder is to tell the controller which sensors are connected to the sensor decoder. Within the decoder functions, select sensor decoder setup. In this screen, you'll be able to assign the decoder's address and the port. We'll assume that we are using 1 sensor decoder for a flow sensor and for a rain click. Therefore, we'll assign address 1, which is the address we programmed into the decoder, and we'll assign port A for the flow sensor input. Since we are using the same decoder, we'll assign the same address for the rain click. But this will be connected through port B. This tells the controller which sensor decoder inputs to look for. Note that if you are unable to select the sensor or the port, it's probably because the sensor decoder has not been assigned to the ADM yet. As soon as the address and ports are configured, the controller will begin polling the sensor decoder for sensor status information. If you haven't installed the decoder in the two-wire path yet, this will cause many unnecessary alarms because the controller will not receive responses from the sensor decoder. If you want to stop this until the sensor decoder is installed, return the dial to the run position and back to advanced features. Go down to decoder functions and go down to sensor decoder alarms. If you change alarms on to alarms off with the plus or minus buttons, the controller will stop polling and generating alarm messages. The controller is not able to receive sensor data in the alarms off setting. You will either need to turn it back on manually, or it automatically will reset to on after 24 hours. So connecting a sensor decoder to the two-wire path is just the same as you would a station decoder. The big difference here, though, is you have to pay attention to the ports A and B on the sensor decoder, so as when they hook up to the sensor, you use the correct wires. As mentioned earlier, when connecting a flow sensor to an ICD SYN, you have to use port A. There's port A and port B available, but port A must be used with a flow sensor. You'll notice on the front it says port A negative. You've got a loop of two purple wires coming out of the top of the decoder. Simply go to the top of the loop, cut the loop so you've got two individual wires. And at that point in time, you want to make sure you take the front purple wire, which is the negative port, and that will be attached to the black wire on your flow sensor. The back purple wire is the positive port, so the back purple wire gets attached to the red wire on the flow sensor. It's very important here, polarity does matter. Negative to black and the positive port to red. Connecting a sensor decoder to a click type sensor involves the same procedure. Here we have the Hunter ICD SYN, our sensor decoder, connected via port A over the purple wires to the black and red wires of the Hunter flow sync. So next, we'll be connecting our rain click rain sensor to port B on the sensor decoder. So we've located our normally closed style rain click sensor close by, and we've decided to run it back to the controller via the two-wire path. We've utilized the orange wires, or port B, on the sensor decoder and connected those two orange wires over to the black and red wire coming from our rain click sensor. And that completes the installation of the ICD sensor decoder. The last function we'll talk about is sensor decoder alarms. From the decoder functions menu, selecting sensor decoder alarms will allow alarm polling down the two-wire path to be temporarily shut off for diagnostic or installation purposes. Be sure to turn the alarms back on when completing the installation or diagnostics. This concludes the decoder functions of the ACC. Make sure to watch our other videos on how to operate the ACC controller. They're available at hunterindustries.com. And thanks for watching.